What's good, family man? It is your boy Ma.
And Sade, and we're back at it again with another video.
Man, you already know somebody's not here to grind, do not stop, man. We're on the road to 70K, so hit that subscribe button, man. But today, y'all, we're at the AMP Blind Day 2, man. Look, we're gonna do probably about a good 20 minutes, then we're gonna do the, like, you know, finish it up another time. So we're gonna break it into sections. That's what a lot of people do when they read the AMP video. The AMP videos be like an hour long video.
Yeah, but let's get like, this one 41 minutes.
Exactly, but let's get to it.
How much money do you have?
Hello?
Hello, is this Mr. Dunn?
Oh, yeah, that's me, that's me.
Hi, this is Mr. Rogers with Intuit Bank. Your $500,000 check just deposited, and this is just a security clearance, just to make sure and let you know that it did go.
Excellent, thank you. Okay.
That's crazy.
What the world?
$500,000 is crazy. If that was real, I don't know. About you, buddy.
Can you hear them?
I'm sorry, buddy. I can't listen.
Love and affection and a minor and sexual touch. We have 5 questions for I Love You Lady. I'll give her the questions. In each question, one person will be eliminated.
Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name's Tyra.
Where
are
you from?
I am from Columbus, Ohio, but I just moved here to Atlanta a couple months ago.
So
the first question is, how soon into dating do you look to have sex?
Is it like multiple choice?
Bro, come on, David.
Two weeks.
Contestant number two?
It ain't a priority. I'm grown. We grown. If it happened, it happened. It don't got no time limit on it.
Right?
Yeah.
He a try-hard.
I was just gonna say, Duke be lying, cause he probably be telling girl. Duke probably be like, oh yeah, like he probably be trying to persuade girls and stuff. Duke be lying.
Contestant number three.
I'ma keep it all sack with you. If you fly, you fly. You feel what I'm saying? We got a little. If I like you and you like me a lot, we could take it slow. But I'ma keep it a sack with you. If things go down, they go down. I'm with anything. Word. Whatever the girl is on, we can move on at our pace.
Contestant number four.
I just want to wait till marriage. You know, I'm not a believer in saying
we've been dating
for 6 months, 6 years. If it gotta be 8 years, we still dating. We didn't get married yet. No sex.
Contestant number five.
Can you repeat the question, please?
How soon into dating do you look to have sex?
How soon? Say it again.
How soon into dating do you look to have sex?
As soon as possible.
Contestant number six.
Immediately.
Couple of y'all need to be going out of that round, but I'm gonna have to eliminate contestant number six. Or if we are out in public and another male compliments me, what do you do?
Nothing. You don't do nothing. It's just, okay, you give my girlfriend a compliment, but nigga, you know your boundaries. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nothing. Because why would I, it's a compliment. Like, you not get compliments. I mean, not you, but like, no, here's what I'm trying to say. It's a compliment. It's a compliment, and like, I'll be giving compliments to people all the time. The compliment is nothing, nothing. Fuck!
Okay. Contestant number two?
Same as number one, man. It ain't, it's a compliment, man. You look good, you look good. You know what I'm saying? As long as he ain't on no disrespect, Tommy. You know what I'm saying? Nothing disrespectful. And you know what I'm gonna say? I'm gonna say, well, I appreciate you. You know what I'm saying? Because you mine already. You know what I'm saying? You out of all people, you know what I'm talking about.
Okay. Contestant number three.
I ain't gonna lie, you feel what I'm saying? I like to treasure mines, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna beat that nigga ass. You know what I'm saying? Like, why are you complimenting my girl when you clearly see me out in public, I'm with her? Like, the fact that you even crossed that line to do that as you see me with her? Like, come on, what's up, though? Like, what's up? Like, why are you on my dick? Like, why?
Okay, heard you. Okay, contestant number four.
I might compliment him, too.
Bro,
poor guy.
What?
I can't and we can't compliment him as a group.
Okay, contestant number five.
Can you please repeat the question?
Oh my god.
You want me to repeat the question? Okay, if we're out in public and another male compliments me, what do you do?
Can you be real? I need to get like the feel of the question. I put myself in the feel of you. I gotta visualize. I accept the compliment. You know what I'm saying? I make sure that you accept the compliment. You know what I'm saying? Respect his decision.
I'ma have to say the one talking about something about some guys, you gonna compliment him back or something.
Oh.
Damn.
What is your longest relationship?
What's name in the relationship?
Who?
What's his name? The first one.
The way y'all react, I'm kind of nervous. Contestant number one.
I will dance.
Yeah, I think he in a relationship.
Just be honest.
Or was.
15 minutes because I don't trust him. I don't trust people like that.
All right. Contestant number two?
Oh, 2 years.
Contestant number three?
My longest relationship was a year and a half.
Like, you don't know?
It was like on and off, too, though.
Oh.
Total time on, though.
All right, total time on, like, 2 months and a half.
All right, so this wasn't pretty hard. I'm gonna have to get rid of number one.
15 minutes for the whole trust.
What's your wildest sexual fantasy? Contestant number two.
It's so real simple. I just want to fuck on a private jet in the air. That's it. Yeah, that's it.
I can't look it.
Okay. We'll talk about that later.
I ain't gonna lie. My dream sex fantasy is I want to fuck on my mom's bed. Like that's like showing like you hold a mad weight and power. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you put on your mom's bed, that means you could do anything. Like, word, that's fire. Like, Ma, look at me, man.
Okay. Contestant number five.
Go
skydiving, throw you off the plane. I jump off the plane, we fucking in the air and all that.
No. Honestly, between 3 and 5, that was kind of hard to pick, but I'm gonna have to go with 3.
That's not what this is about.
You got eliminated me. How you doing, beloved?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Would you ever be a stepdad?
Would I ever be a stepdad? How many kids you got?
She got one.
You know what? This is something I can't even troll about. Yeah, I could, you know what I'm saying, because I
have
a stepdad.
You sure?
I have a stepdad. It was solid, you know what I'm saying? So, I can do that right there. I can't trust. Yeah.
You don't sound too positive.
No. 1,000% absolutely correct.
Okay, contestant number five.
He's
stepdad too, but he got to call me dad. His dad, he got to call him by his first name.
I'm gonna have to get rid of contestant number five.
I know it.
I'm the dad that stepped up.
You the dad that stepped up.
Man, you the dad that stepped up.
Hey.
Oh boy. Oh, how you doing?
Why is she fanning herself when she gonna pass out or something?
You had a vision?
Yeah, like from your voice.
Yeah,
I like the name. Oh, really? See, man, we hit it off on the right note off the grid. How old are you?
I'm 21.
Oh, okay. How are you today?
26.
Hey, man, we're going to link up.
Okay, what's your name?
My name is Emmeline.
What's your age?
How old you thought he was?
I knew he was older, but 26?
Nah, not really old, y'all. Not that old.
Not saying like old, but I'm saying like...
He don't look at the age.
Yeah, like he don't look like he 26. Like 26, that's...
I'm 32.
Where are you from?
I am from Ackworth right now.
You ready to find love?
We'll see.
Let's go do it. Come on.
Thank you. First date. Are you paying or am I paying?
I'm not paying. Fred, because I don't know you like that. If I like get to know you and we vibe out, then I'll think about it. You know what I'm saying? But nah.
Number two?
Am I paying? Yeah. But second date, just hit me out. Second date, I'ma leave my wallet in the car on purpose.
Hey,
then I'ma say, hey, I forgot my wallet. And if you say, depends on what you say. If you say, oh no, I got it, you know what I'm saying, then we good. But if you say, oh no, let's turn around real quick, then you cut off. Cause that means you don't wanna, you know what I'm saying, do the same for me like I do for you.
Okay, dude, okay, that was a good answer.
I'm not gonna lie to you, I like to go with independence, you feel what I'm saying? You gotta show me you're independent. You gotta show me you can hold it down. Show me that you don't need me, you feel what I'm saying? So I'll pay for it, I'm not gonna lie, but show me like, no, I got it. Like, let's argue a little bit over the table, you feel what I'm saying? Let's argue a little bit, like, well, who gonna pay, you feel what I'm saying?
Bro,
like
what is this man talking about, bro?
Because I'm a kinky nigga, but besides that,
no, I get what he's saying though. He's saying like, put up a fight, like make it seem like you know, like how some girls you take them on a date and they just be like, they don't offer to pay, they don't say nothing, they just be like, oh, they just be sitting there, and you know. But he's saying like, at least say like, oh, I'll pay this time and you pay next time, or you know, something like that. Yeah.
And but it'd be so weird though. It's weird though when like your girl pull out her card to pay for me. Like, it's so weird. Like, yeah, from a guy perspective, it's weird to see, like, say y'all eating dinner and agree, you know how the girl, like, I'm gonna take you out this time, then she pay for it. It's like, right, it just feel weird.
Yeah, I take you out for special occasions like your birthday and stuff.
That's a lie. No, you don't.
I did take you out
for more than just my birthday.
No, like when we want to have lunch, like when I want to have lunch and I want to treat you to lunch, I do. Oh, so it'd be vice versa.
Alright, 4?
Nah, I'll pay. But you gotta pay for the taxes. The tips. Shit, my bad. And don't do no little shit.
I think that's fair,
that's
too.
Fair too, yeah.
Like, we do that sometimes. Like, if you might have a card, if you're using a card and I have cash, I'll pay, like, I'll leave the tip. So I can, so I understand that.
David's
gone. You're trying to throw in like $2.23. No, you're not throwing like $10 in that bitch or some shit. You know what I'm saying?
Now you speak the fast right now. All right.
Number 5.
I'm definitely not paying. You definitely not paying either, because we both eating at my mom's house that day. So yeah, that's a fact.
I like that. You taking her to meet your mama off the grill?
My mom could tell me if she the vibe or not.
Okay.
Alright, number 6.
Usually when I'm going on dates, I'm going to places I want to go to. So like if I'm going with somewhere crazy, I'll pay for it. But like after the first date though, you had to show me something you're interested in. You know what I'm saying? So it works back and forth. That way we get to know each other, you know? If you like plants and shit, take me to the garden. And I like steak, so I bring you to a nice spot.
He never really did answer the question.
If it's my spot, I'm paying.
He said no, but he's saying like he out of the ordinary stuff, like he like going to steakhouse and stuff. So he's saying like he would pay for the steakhouse,
but, like,
but when it comes time for her to do something, which she is something that interests her, she should pay for it. Like if they want to go to a garden or if they want to go to the zoo, she should pay for that. He's saying that he got expensive taste, so he'll pay for his stuff, like his stuff that he want to take her to see.
Or what if she don't got that rail at that time?
Alright, I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to eliminate number 1.
I know it.
Number 1?
You get eliminated in the first round.
How do you feel about thick women?
Right.
Am I right?
Right. Now, me personally, man, I feel like ain't nothing wrong with them. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing wrong with a thick.
Where you going with this? Where you going?
They alright, man. I'm 50-50, man. Skinny, thick, I don't know, man. They alright. It's a lot more work. You know what I'm saying? So low key, I prefer slim thick over thick. You know what I'm saying? You get what I'm saying?
Alright.
I don't get what he's saying. He's out of here.
Size, you Rosa. I love it. It gives me a challenge. You feel what I'm saying? And I love challenges. Like I will rap around and just do that right there. You feel what I'm saying? It's Jay business. You feel what I'm saying? And the poom poom warm. You know what I'm saying? The poom poom is so warm. It's so nice. And thick women know how to cook. No cap.
Just so you fit, they don't mean you know how to cook.
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying all the thick women I've talked to, when they whip it up for me, they're busting.
All right, number four.
If you're talking about like the size of the woman, you know, I'm in love and cherish her. My mama baby, you know what I'm saying? So it's like
Nah, he violated. Bro, he violated bad.
Number four.
If you're talking about like the size of the woman, you know, I'm in love and cherish her. My mama baby, you know what I'm saying? So it's like
No, the way he said it
made
eye contact with me. Stop.
Have
some respect. Say it again, bro.
Yeah, I didn't quite hear.
I'm sorry, man. Before I was rudely interrupted by this nigga over here. But
I take them as they come. I don't care if they skinny. I don't care if they big. I don't care if, you know what I'm saying? I'll do it all. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I've experienced myself with more thick women than slim women. And so I know my way around and shit like that. But the issue is a lot of thick women like to make that their personality. Like, because they thick, that's it. Like, that's all they take. So it's like, how I feel about it is like, I mean, like, I need to see something more.
Number six.
I like women thick. I like them big too, but off the rip, probably first date, I'm gonna need you to sit on my face.
Damn.
Oh, yeah, you got it.
Yeah, you got it.
There's no code word necessary. You know what I'm saying?
Sorry, I'm gonna have to eliminate number two.
Didn't have an explanation.
What's your preferred hairstyle?
I don't really have a preference in the hairstyle thing. You feel what I'm saying? I'm looking at your face, your smile, and your personality. Whether you want to go natural, whatever you want to do, I don't really care. If you want to do finger waves with it, I don't care. If you wanna wear wigs, I be seeing girls' wigs. It be looking laid. I like the colors. I like the edges laid and all that. I don't really have a preference.
So all right, number four.
You know, if you got the Boosie fade and she like that, and
she got a little haircut.
As long as she don't got like a mohawk or some shit, I think we should. I think we good. You know what I'm saying?
Number five.
It just gotta look good, or if you make it look good too, I really don't care.
And number six.
Curly hair, but natural hair too. Though, just natural state. You at your default. You know what I'm saying? As long as you have like a mohawk or something weird. If I'm explaining your hairstyle to people, then it's too much.
I like that mohawk.
Like, if she's like, yo, she got a mohawk? I'm like, damn, I don't want to feel those questions.
A girl with a mohawk and tattoos is tough. I like that mohawk.
So I think we're gonna have to eliminate number four.
Woo! He said low haircut.
How
he said boosie
big are you?
He said he liked her.
She's somebody big.
Well, if you want to know how big I am, how about you come find out?
She might have got offense when he said Boosie.
Yeah, she might have.
How about you come find out your sexy ass? Come find out. You going to like what you see. That's what I got to say.
All right, number five. How big are you?
So you're not going to stop calling me back?
Shit. What?
No.
I still didn't hear you.
It's really small.
Okay. Number six, how big are you?
See, that's a setup, because I got an OnlyFans. You trying to, you know, cut away from my bag, so you got to subscribe to your OnlyFans and see that.
Business.
Make her pay for this.
Like
everybody
else.
Man.
I'm
going to
eliminate number five.
Because I said two different answers before that.
But just because you
small,
she
want to
pack you
up. I just couldn't hear what you said. Would you let me dominate you?
First of all, when it comes to that sex and that sex game, I'm more dominant in that. I love taking control. Let me take control. But I will say, I love when a girl dominates. Talk to me nasty and freaky and all that. Tell me what it is. Tell me what's on your mind. Take control a little bit. Don't be the pilot, because I'm the pilot. But you can go ahead and take control a little bit. I like it. Choke? Nah, you can't choke me. You choke me, you're done. All right. Go, Agent, your turn.
I'm open to really anything, but I probably wouldn't enjoy it though. I'd do it just because you enjoyed it, but I'd expect you to be doing the same shit for me though. If I tell you, like, we're doing this, you can't say nah, because you just got done dominating me, so what are we talking about?
Alright, number
6.
Let's go, bro.
I gotta eliminate you.
Gotta find the love in your life.
What's this answer?
I know. I'm just really trying to, cause Kai does ignorant stuff, and I just
you probably start laughing.
And I just don't want him to do nothing ignorant. Just please don't do it.
Come here. How you doing? Nice to meet you. I believe you have to go on a date now.
Come on. First of all, let me talk about you. You're really beautiful. I ain't gonna lie. You look good.
You're very cute.
Thank you. I appreciate you. Let me ask you this, honey. Let me get a little closer.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Based on looks, smash or pass?
I'll smash.
Okay.
I'm
taking you down.
This is a beautiful day, though. Nice to meet you.
Beautiful day.
Come on. Let me walk you back, my lady. Come on. Do your thing.
My name is Taylor Watts.
I'm freaking dead.
I am weak. Oh my god.
I'm Jasmine. Ass or titty?
Dead ass.
I like that ass.
I don't really care about titties like that. Only when you sleep.
That's when it like pillow.
Oh, when you in the middle of like sex and you sucking on the
mommy.
I'm going to go with number 2. Contestant 2.
A nigga said Google Gaga, you know what I'm saying?
If we go on a date and I bring a friend, are you paying for them too?
Boy! Why they gotta be the stupid question? Like, boy, no. She should be.
Are you paying for them?
She said one more time.
Are you listening?
Oh, what the hell?
Oh,
how to him? Of course I'm listening. Can you repeat it again?
Okay, this is my last time for contestant 1. If we go on a date and I bring a friend, are you paying for them?
Repeat it one more time.
I know that she's tired.
He had to make a statement.
You really didn't hear me for real.
Huh?
I am weak.
Alright, I'm gonna eliminate contestant 1 since you didn't answer.
Wait, who'd you eliminate?
You gotta look it up.
Contestant 1. You ain't hear that either?
One more time.
Nah, that'd be
What's the
angry.
Oldest you would date?
49. Once you hit 50, you done. 49 and between the ages of 18 and 49. One.
Contestant 4. Okay.
So he's on like
90 time.
You said 70.
Well, that's bad. As long as she loves me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he like 19.
What?
Yeah, he like 19. I think he was in his second year of college when he dropped out.
Wow.
He'd be a junior. He'd be like 19, 20. He might just turn 20.
I think I'm gonna eliminate contestant 4. What's the freakiest place you ever had sex?
On a roof of a project building. I'm from the trenches. Bottom to top.
Contestant 5.
Under a bed.
Bro, why are you under the bed? Get in the bed, bro.
You have to get in the bed from the side.
No.
Like a blanket or like...
It was just a bed. I don't know what that
the bed
was. It was a bed, like a queen.
It's a toilet.
What?
You said in the toilet? Did he say in the toilet or on the toilet?
Dead ass. You had to get your ass from the side.
No. Like a blanket or like...
It was just a bed. I don't know what that
bed was.
I'm big enough. It was a bed like a queen.
It's a toilet.
What?
Oh.
Dead ass right now?
That's like a little too much. I'm shitting together.
He said, I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to eliminate number 6.
What? Toilet is crazy.
What do you consider
a toilet?
Oh. I ain't gonna lie, man. A toilet is crazy.
Why would you want to do it on the toilet?
What do I consider cheating? Anything of any form of entertaining other niggas. Meaning, if you over here, if a nigga post a funny ass status, you start laughing under this. Fuck are you laughing under his status for? Like, why are you entertaining that nigga?
Fuck are you talking about?
You feel what I'm saying? And I'm not, and it may sound, oh, you insecure. You think, nah, I just like the respect. Cause I'm not about to be laughing under no girl status. Like, what's up?
So I can't have friends?
I didn't say that, sweetheart. You can have friends. But who the fuck is that nigga?
Contestant 5.
I don't have no.
You think so?
Cheating, like I don't have a. I don't have a what's it called? A spectrum for how bad the cheating is. 9 times out of 10, I'm already cheating myself.
No, Phantom out of here.
Yeah, Phantom gone.
He's going. Y'all,
yeah, we gonna have to start doing more AMP videos.
Cause y'all be saying, bro, please do AMP, bro. I'm happy y'all start doing AMP. Y'all will go up, y'all do more AMP.
Yeah, we gonna start doing AMP for y'all.
Man, but other than that, man, y'all already know what to do, man. Please.
Like, comment, subscribe, turn on post notifications, subscribe to all 3 channels, all 3 channels, all 3 channels.
Follow me and Charlie both on Instagram, man. But other than that, man, we out of here.